I'm Rick McGuire. I'm the executive editor of CardioSource Interventional News, and I'm with Cesar Iliescu, and we're from MD Anderson Cancer Center, a place that has a new Cath lab, correct?
It's true, Rick. So we have the first Cath lab in a cancer center in the world, and the reason is, looking backwards, we call this a double jeopardy. All our patients smoke, don't exercise, a little bit overweight. So they get the basically two penalties. One is the cancer, and the other one is the heart disease. And unfortunately, in all our cardiovascular trials, we've excluded all the cancer patients. So there's no know-how of how to treat these patients. And on the other hand, on the oncology side, all our patients are excluded from their trials as well because of the cardiovascular disease.
And chronic thrombocytopenia is a challenge, but some of these people, that's becoming pretty much their life. So if you're going to avoid interventions, these patients have got a real problem.
You're absolutely right. You're absolutely right. We have a new subgroup of patients, of cancer survivors, young folks in the 40s, 50s, surviving leukemia, lymphomas, predominantly hematological malignancies, and they basically present with a non-ST elevation, ST elevation myocardial infarction with baseline chronic thrombocytopenias in the 30s, 40s. But those platelets, actually, they work really well.
Why? Why do they have chronic thrombocytopenia?
It's from chemotherapy, radiation to the bone marrow with myelosuppression. It's going to be there forever. So these patients, they're not going to be treated for cardiovascular disease forever. And they're going to basically, we're going to see the natural history of myocardial infarction now in the 21st century. And that's a group of patients where we can save them.
Why the need for a cardiac cath lab in an oncology center like MD Anderson?
First of all, is majority of our patients are above 50. So, and again, 65% of them are cancer survivors, which is a very, very large group of patients. And if you look at the volume of patients with no know-how of treating them, it is an absolutely big gap. Looking just for the state of Texas, we had 101,000 patients diagnosed with cancer last year. And nationwide, 1.5 million patients diagnosed with cancer, out of which more than half have any form of heart disease, and we have no knowledge how to treat them. So actually, in our cath lab, we treat only cancer patients. And our procedures, obviously, we have higher volume of acute coronary syndromes, obviously restrictive constrictive cardiomyopathy, a lot of biopsies that we do, and a lot of other interesting cases. We do tumor biopsies in the heart. So it's a new field, obviously, that we're opening.
How do patients get referred to you?
They're all cancer patients, and actually, by opening this new field of cancer and the heart, we're getting patients referred from all over the world, actually, for just treating them for cardiovascular disease.
Any challenges with the chronic thrombocytopenia patients that just make your life a little bit more challenging?
Two things we've noticed is, above 50,000, most of these patients behave like normal platelets. So above 50,000, we do not do anything different. We get access, in all our cases, micropuncture technique and micropuncture kit, and then we prefer to go radial in most of our cases because of the thrombocytopenia, if possible. Below 50,000, it's an open group. We've done patients with lowest platelets count of 4. We never transfuse them because we do not want to transfuse activated platelets throughout this procedure, so promote an acute coronary syndrome, and we didn't have increased risk of bleeding. Again, we are always careful about hemostasis, and we exclude all the patients that are septic, active bleeding. So all these patients with thrombocytopenia, it's a mark of severity, actually, and not really a chronic thrombocytopenia. So we have this acute and the chronic thrombocytopenia. Our patients are chronic thrombocytopenic, so with a baseline low platelets.
So do you think there'll be more complementary places like this in the future where we're going to combine cardiology and oncology?
It's an absolute need. Actually, the volume is increasing, and the interest nationwide is increasing in this field, cancer, the heart. We had already 2 meetings, and the participation is really unbelievable, just because all these patients are, vast majority of them actually, are cancer survivors. So it's an absolute need for knowledge in this field, cancer in the heart.
And you went and found some cardiovascular specialists to come to MD Anderson?
We actually, it's interesting. You'd think, you know, we had 2 or 3 of us, and actually our group, we have 13 cardiologists. And we have a full spectrum, including interventional cardiology, electrophysiology. So yes, we're really all spectrum of patients.
I love this. And you can read more about this and see the facility for yourself at CardioSource Interventional News. I'm Rick McGuire. Thank you.